Hello friends, now we will convert this epsilon NFA into a TFA. How to convert this epsilon NFA into TFA means by computing the epsilon closure for each and every state. First we will start with the start state, that is first we have to find out the epsilon closure of the start state. Here the start state is P. So epsilon closure of P is equal to first include the state P. Next the epsilon transitions out of P. Out of P means from P where we are moving for the epsilon transition, that is to the state Q and also to the state R. So include the state Q and R in the epsilon closure of P. Next we have to extend the state PQR for the three input symbols A, B and C. First we will extend for the symbol A, del of P, A, union Q, A, union del of R, A. What is del of P, A? What are the transitions from P for the input symbol A? There is no transitions out of the state P for the input symbol A. So it is equal to pi union del of Q, A. From Q for the symbol A, that is to the state P. That is to the state P, it is equal to P union del of R, A. There is no transition from R for the input symbol A. So it is also equal to pi. It is equal to the state P. Finally, we have to find out the epsilon closure of the state P. What is epsilon closure of the state P? Already we calculated the epsilon closure for the state P as P, Q, R. It is equal to P, Q, R. That is P, Q, R for the input symbol A is transition to the state, same state P, Q, R. Next, we have to extend the state del of P, Q, R for the input symbol B. And again for the same state del of P, Q, R for the input symbol C. Like this we have to find out the transitions of the state P, Q, R. P, Q, R, B is equal to, it can be written as del of P, B union del of Q, B union del of R, B. It is equal to, what is it? Here we extended the state PQR for the input symbol A and for the input symbol B and for input symbol C. PQR, A is the cell transition, that is the same state PQR, that is equal to PQR. PQR, A is equal to PQR. PQR, B is equal to QR. That is different transition. Here the state QR is considered as a new state. Next we have to extend the state QR for the input symbol A, B and C, right? Next PQR, C. PQR, C is equal to PQR, that is also cell transition. For C also here we got the cell transition to the state PQR, right? So next we have to extend the state QR. Here QR is the only new state. Extend the state QR for the input symbol A, that is Q, A union R, A. That is equal to P union pi. There is no transition for the input symbol A from R. So it is equal to pi. It is equal to P. Next thing is, at last we have to find out the epsilon closure of this state. Epsilon closure of P is equal to PQR. So the transition from the state QR for the input symbol A is to the state PQR. The transition from the state QR for the input symbol A is to the state PQR. Likewise, QR, B is to the state R and QR, C is to the state PQR. Right? Here, the new state considered will be considered as called as the state R. Right? The state R will be considered as the new state. Next, we have to extend the state R for the input symbol A, B and C. Right? What is the transition for the state from R for the input symbol A and from R for the input symbol B and from R for the input symbol C? Right? That three transitions we have to extend. How we will extend? Del of
she needs help, she needs right here now.
Del of R, A means from the state R for the input symbol A. Is there any transition for the input symbol A from the state R? No. So it is equal to pi. There is no such transition. Epsilon closure of pi is also pi. Next, del of R, B. What is R, B? From R, what is the transition from for B? There is no outgoing transition for R. So all the transitions are equal to pi. R, A, R, B, R, C is equal to pi. right? So what are the state we have to consider for constructing the DFA? First thing is we have to consider the state PQR, and next state is PR, right? And the last state is we have to consider here R. But for R there is no outgoing transition. The state, three states considered for constructing DFA is PQR, the second state is PR, first one is PQR, PQR, this is a single state, and next one is QR is another state, and last one is the state R, right? Here which one is the final state? The R will be considered as the final state. So all the three states are called as the final states of this DFA. And what are the transitions for PQR? For the input symbol A, here what is the transition? Silk transition. For the input symbol A, from the state PQR is the silk transition. For A, silk transition. For B, it is to the state QR. For B, it is to the state QR. And for C, it is to the state PQR. That is silk transition. A comma C. And for the state QR, for the state QR comma A, what is the transition? That is to the state PQR for the input symbol A. For the input symbol B, it is to the state R. And for the input symbol C, again it is to the state PQR. And for R, there is no outgoing transition, only it is having some incoming transition. This is the equivalent DFA for this epsilon NFA. First, we have to consider the start state, epsilon close of the start state, right? And that particular state is extended for all the alphabets, all the symbols in the alphabets. If you are having 2 or if you are having 3, we have to extend for all the symbols. Here in our example, we are having 3 symbols in our alphabet, A, B, C. So, we extended the state for A, B and C, right? The resultant, for the resultant state, again at last we have to find out the epsilon closure. Epsilon closure for each and every end state of each and every transitions, right? If you are having any new statement, that new state will also be extended for the symbols A, B and C. If there is an existing statement, that will not be considered for further extension, right? Now this is the equivalent DFA for this epsilon NFA, right? Thank you.